I think it is necessary for people to be aware that these kinds of things do happen. And more than just physical, but also people being taken advantage of.
As the elderly population continues to grow here in Montreal on World Elder Abuse Awareness Day, some say the problem is bigger than we might think.
At least 20% of the calls I get are people concerned about some type of abuse. And of course, it's only going to become bigger. The demographics are shifting. We have more and more of an aging population, and we have less and less resources to support that population, which makes them more and more vulnerable and at risk.
Take 78-year-old Frida Goldfinger, a full-time caregiver for her 90-year-old husband who suffers from dementia. She's uneasy about what would happen to him if she could no longer care for him and be forced to place him in a home.
I would be very worried, and I would think that I would probably want to be there for a large part of the time to make sure that nothing did occur like that.
This is a very real concern for many of her age, especially Goldfinger, a retired head nurse at the Jewish General Hospital. She says she's witnessed how the elderly can sometimes be mistreated by the system.
Sometimes being very rough with them, not being kind, not changing them when they needed to be changed, and you allow people to lie in their excrement. That is a very difficult thing to see.
Experts say the best way to conquer that uneasiness is to be proactive while you're still well, putting your care wishes in place.
Have open and honest and proactive conversations with your family so you can set up a support system. So if one day you're vulnerable or at risk, you have the right people in the right place at the right time.
But if you're like Frida and her husband, whose family all live abroad, support can be best found with local groups like SARPAD, where Frida, fellow caregivers, and vulnerable people living alone share their experiences about what it is to be elderly in this city. In Montreal, Alyssia Rubertucci, City News.